Vishal Sarkar here. In today's video, I want to talk to you about five things in life that that never come back. And if you want to really achieve high level of happiness and a great level of peace of mind, I think some of these you already know, but it's not about just knowing, it's about reminding yourself. Because, you know, a wise man once said that a foolish man thinks that he always has to learn just new things, but a wise man always has to be reminded of old lessons that are very, very practical and very, very wise. So I wanna talk to you about the five things in life that never come back. And that's number one, that is the lost opportunity. A lost opportunity. Sometimes you miss out on an opportunity in your career, maybe to make new friends, maybe to lose an opportunity to travel a specific part of the world that you can't go back right now because of time and other things. So a lost opportunity is something that you should understand that never comes back. I mean, other opportunities might come, but not that lost opportunity. So make sure that you do everything in your power to not lose any opportunity.
Hi, this is Bharti. I work for a pharmaceutical company. I have met Mr. Vishal during September 2017. There are many life lessons which I have learned, and all these life lessons had great impact on my life. Stop seeking approval, nothing to hide and nothing to prove, which had a great impact on my life, and they have completely changed the perspective of my life. I was always an approval seeker right from my childhood, which never allowed me to stay in peace. Now I no more seek approval from anyone, which has increased my peace. And also I am not trying to prove before anyone, which has increased my confidence.
Number two, a dead person never comes back. I mean, I remember I've lost some family members in my life, and the closest one that I had was my grandmother. And I remember when I went to the hospital to see her dead body, because, you know, she had a sudden heart issue at night, in the middle of the night. When I went, and it a matter of like 45 minutes before I even reached there, she expired. And when I saw my grandmother, I remember in the hospital, and I was taking her from the bed to the stretcher after her death. It was a very heavy moment for me, not a good moment. And no matter how much I cry for other people, including some of the, you know, deaths of some friends, some family members, dead people never come back. So there is no point talking good about those people later on when they are gone. I think it's very important for you to celebrate their presence while they are alive right now here, while they are here right now, to share their happiness. So if there are people in your life, your friends, family member, a colleague, a neighbor that you really appreciate, make sure the next time you see them, that can be the last time also. So make sure that you understand the preciseness of life that Gautam Buddha always talked about, that life is short, life is precise, and life is important. So make sure you do that.
Positive affirmations. I think that's something I should be telling you. That's you know, one of the things that I've actually learned from Vishal Sarkar's course. So before I go for presentation, I keep on telling myself, you know, that I am confident. I can actually go and make good speeches. I am going to be valuable to the audience. You know, when you actually tell those speech, you get that energy, you get the high to actually go and give the presentation. And I think Vishal taught me that, and that's why now I'm more confident.
Third thing that never comes back in life is a spoken word. And this is something that I've been a victim of in my life, where I say something bad to somebody and later on I feel, oh my God, I shouldn't have said that. But a spoken word that once gone never comes back. So make sure that you're very precise, very intentional with your words. And of course, at times we get angry and emotional, but make sure that you don't vomit your emotions onto somebody else. Okay, that's third. Number four, a fired bullet. When you really fire a bullet, that never comes back. You know, just like words, once it's released, it's completely released. It goes, it never comes back. And the fifth one is a wasted moment. A wasted moment. I see this oftentimes. People lose moments after moments, and when you lose a moment and you lose it enough times, you lose a day. And when you lose enough days, you lose a week. When you lose enough weeks, you lose a month. When you lose enough months, you lose a year. When you lose enough years, you lose a decade. And when you lose enough decades, you lose a lifetime. What are you losing right now? I want you to think about that, because I don't care how old you are. Maybe you're 35, 40, 45, and just like many of my clients, maybe 50. Or 55, but if you are at a stage in your life where you feel like your life is precious and you can't waste any more time, then you don't waste any more time from now. Make sure you seize all the opportunity, get the mentorship, get the coaching, learn the right stuff, and it can change your life forever. So these are the five things that you need to understand that never comes back. Is number one, a lost opportunity, number two, a dead person, number three, a spoken word, number four, a fired bullet, and number five, a wasted opportunity. Okay, that's my tip for you right now. Make sure that you make the most out of life, because I don't know how old you are, but I know that you can be more bold in your life. I don't know what's the current quality of your life, but I know that you want a better quality of your life. And I don't know exactly how many years you have left in your life, but I know that you can make the rest of your life the best of your life. Vishal Sarkar here reminding you that public speaking is not about perfection, it's all about connection.
Hi, this is Sarita Pradhan. I'm from Sikkim. I am basically a headmistress of a government school. Before coming here, I had the problem of not being able to connect with the students since I run the school. And another thing, I didn't know how to wrap up the entire presentation at the end. So those are the two problem I used to face.
Just enroll it. Don't think about it twice. My name is Prabhat Mehrotra, and I'm a delivery manager in one of the IT software companies in Bangalore.
Hi, I am Kripa. I work as operations manager in Bangalore. My biggest challenge is I went through some, you know, lowest point in my life. So I was finding it very difficult to, you know, talk to people. I used to corner myself. I didn't have a courage to go in front of people and, you know, place myself in a right position.
I would say that slowly I'm trying to come out of my own shell. I'm being more positive because of all the emails, feeds that I'm getting every day. So every day, the first thing I do is like I open my phone, I read out the thing, you know, send the letter sent to me, and I share with my sisters and my daughter. So I every day I'm being very positive, and those are the thing I think, you know.
So to be very honest, before I came to the conference, I was facing nervousness and anxiety. That is something which was very chronic to me from past many years, and I really wanted to overcome that. I did some spiritual programs, I did a lot of yoga. It did not help me to overcome that. So I really wanted to get into some practical course.
It was a setback in my life. Now after when I found out this Vishal Sarkar's website, when I went through and I started, it's been a journey, you know, though it is a short journey till now.
He has some special quality to see the drawbacks, the thing which you want to improve in you, and he does it automatically without you knowing it, that he is doing it. So that is the great thing for me.
So three things I would talk about through this conference which I have gained. One is to kind of respect yourself, to take appreciations, and also I was able to calm myself down, and I got some techniques and tips to overcome some of the nervousness and anxiety before I go to the stage. Vishal is one of the most powerful mentors whom we have. The kind of techniques which he tells is very practical and apt to the current world right now, and not very bookish. So if we just follow whatever he says and apply at least 50% of the techniques which he has told, I'm very sure that you'll be a much more confident man.
I thought there is a place where I can explore myself, my potential. So it's basically unlocking myself. Conference has been very practical. It is not like a Jnan session. It was very practical. It kept me holding on to, you know, every point, every word Vishal was speaking. I could relate very well to my situations and what I can expect and where I want to go. This was precisely what I was looking for.
Okay, guys, I think all of you should come and do this course, because not only you get a chance to meet so many people, mentor so many lovely teams, but also you come out of yourself, you become a better version of yourself, you become more positive. So guys, please come.
Just enroll it. Don't think about it twice.
You can just rely on him and he will make changes in you. And I think there is no second thought about considering him as your mentor. Blindly take a call, go ahead and register yourself, and be part of this program.